This is the part for setting the sound levels. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, stop. The Australian Christmas is during the summer, so we take an extended Christmas holiday and leave Sydney heading for Queensland, the Sunshine State. After 3 days' travel, we arrive at the coast on Christmas Eve, Christopher's birthday.
Chris is looking forward to his first ever helicopter flight, and for that matter, it's the first helicopter flight for the rest of the family, too.
Helicopter!
It should be exciting. This is the first time we've been in a helicopter.
Oh, we have to wear a lot of life jackets.
Well, you've always wanted to try one on.
We get.
Go on, you go next, Lucy.
This is no joyride. We're on a scheduled air service taking us to a coral island 45 miles off the Australian mainland.
We'll be staying on Heron Island for Christmas.
Come on!
Are you enjoying it, Chris?
Yes, Daddy.
See, there it is.
The island is tiny. You can walk around it in half an hour. It's named after the heron that nests here, which is much smaller than a normal heron, as you can see by comparing it with a seagull.
Oh, Chris! Chris, you fool! Lucy, just remember to blow when you come up from underneath. Blow out before you breathe in. Oh, Chris.
I bet he won't use it.
Blow, come on, blow. Oh, it's cheating. Just you remember to blow.
Mummy looks funny.
These pictures were taken through a glass viewing box while I was standing in the water.
The interior of the island is dense jungle that belongs to the birds. There are more knotty terns on the island than any other species, although we also glimpse the rare white heron.
There you go. Come on, Chris.
Daddy, we can go.
Heron Island attracts many professional photographers. This is Japan's leading underwater photographer. We would later see his afternoon's work in TV adverts with this young lady underwater with a manta ray.
The coral reef surrounding Heron Island is one of the most varied concentrations of marine life in the world. All you have to do to appreciate it is to don a mask, snorkel and flippers and go see for yourself.
These pictures, filmed off still photographs, are some of the fish we saw beneath the sea around Heron Island. Some beautiful, some rather startling. A clownfish. The weird flute fish. A harmless shovel-nosed shark. The rather alarming leopard eel. The attractive coral fish. A rock cod. A shoal of catfish. And the beautiful blue angel. Some sea creatures come out onto the beach. The most notable can only be seen at this time of year, and at night, when the giant turtles come to Heron Island to lay their eggs.
John and I watched as they lumber up the beach and prepare a nest in the sand. Then, in a deep hole dug with their rear flippers, they lay over 100 eggs. They carefully cover them with sand and return to the sea. The next day, with the children, we hunt for the site of one of the nests we had seen the previous night.
Where are we going today?
We're going to look for the turtles' nests.
Oh. How will we know when we found it?
Well, you have to look for the track. See, here it is. You can see the mark where it's dragged its tummy along the sand. And then it came here and made this big nest and threw all the sand out to the side like so. And then she sat in the middle and laid her eggs and then covered them all up again.
We're really lucky. A turtle comes out of the sea in daylight. Chris and I can see how big it is, over 5 feet from head to tail.
Isn't it huge?
Realizing her mistake, the turtle hurries back to the safety of the sea.
Come on, kids, the helicopter's coming.
It's time for us to leave Heron Island.
tide is very low, and the view of the coral from the helicopter is rather reminiscent of the TV pictures from spacecraft over the moon. Only the white triangular shape of a ray reminds us that this is not outer space, but the inner space of the Great Barrier Reef.